Holy Ghost. Can you guys do me a favor this morning? If you're listening, you can watch us on Facebook Live. Or if you're watching, share this right now on your Facebook. Share this on your social media, on Twitter, all the good places. Invite your friends to watch this program. This morning, we're talking about stay away from them. Whoa. Stay away from them. This should be very interesting.
People are like, what is he,
talking about? What is them? Who is
that
them?
That doesn't sound very kingdom. What's going on?
That doesn't sound kingdom. Stay away from them. Like, how is that kingdom, Alice? That's a very good question. So we're going to answer some of these questions today. Stay away from them. I feel the glory. I feel the glory. Okay, guys. So this is what I want us to do. I want you to go. Grab yourself a cup of coffee. Get ready. This morning we're going to talk about some things this morning, and we're just getting started. So if this is your first time listening to the program here on RadioAirJesus.com, we welcome you. Thank you so much for spending your morning with us this morning, and we pray that you're blessed and that you're impacted and that you would hear a word from the Lord that would just really touch your heart this morning. You know, and our heart is just to see people impacted, and that's what we just want to see. You know, amen. So this morning we're going to talk about stay away from them. And I really want to, I don't know if I'm really just to jump in yet. You know,
I'll jump in for you.
You just want to jump in?
Yeah, let's go.
No, Alice. No. We have to have order.
No, let's be free. Wow, then let's go for it.
What was that commercial goes? There's no rules. There's one rule. No. I'm going to read out of a 2 Timothy. For those who follow me on Facebook and you guys are kind of familiar with us a little bit, I tend to write things that the Lord gives me. And I'm going to pull this up real quick on my...
That are kind of thought-provoking.
Thought-provoking.
That's what we were talking about this morning.
Because, you know, we said it this morning, and I love how Alice said it. She said, stay away from them. Right? That's what we said. And then, like, well, that's not kingdom. And you know that... So what do you think? What do you think by that statement alone? I want to get you guys involved with this. We're gonna make this an interactive video live stream and radio.
If you're talking about Timothy, Timothy was one that was one to just bring forth the truth. I mean, if there's anything you can talk about Timothy is that he always brought the truth forward. He always lived on the edge and talked about things that nobody else was really talking about during those times.
Yeah.
And so when he shares this verse, it's really, really good because it was during a time that it needed to be shared during this moment. He was dealing with all this, in other words.
Well, we're going to read out of 2 Timothy, and we're going to be out of 2 Timothy chapter 3. And for those who don't know, Paul was writing to the church and Timothy and giving instruction. So let me just kind of, we'll just jump in. Let me get up my word here. Let me read this because we said, is it even kingdom? So I'm going to read out of 2 Timothy chapter 3. You should know this, Timothy, that in the last days there will be difficult times for the people. For people will love themselves and their money. They will be boastful and proud, scoffing at God, disobedient to their parents, ungrateful. They will consider nothing sacred. They will be unloving, unforgiving. They will slander others. They will have no self-control. They will be cruel and hate what is good. They will betray their friends. They will be reckless. They will be puffed up with pride. They will love the pleasures rather than God. And then verse 5. Listen to verse 5. They will act religious, but they will reject the power that can make them godly. And then the last part says, stay away from people like that.
Mine says, have nothing to do with such people. And mine's NIV. But even in the front part of that, in the NIV, it says, but mark this. In other words, mark my words.
Yeah.
Like, mark my words, listen to me, like trying to get our attention to really, really understand and grasp what they're saying here. It's like a forewarning, like, hey, there are people like this out there and you need to just stay away from them.
Well, you know, this is what I want us to do. Okay. So again, we're calling this morning, stay away from them. That's what we're calling the program this morning. So if you're watching right now on Facebook and you're on social media, can you please share this? I really want people to share this because I feel like there's going to be breakthrough today.
Right.
There's going to be breakthrough. We're gonna talk about, we're going to give you areas to give you insight that your eyes would be enlightened, that you would see and hear what the Spirit of the Lord is saying this morning. So again, we also want to engage with you. If you have any comments or prayer requests, please leave them on our Facebook page and where we're streaming the video live. And we want to be able to answer those questions as they come in, okay? So let's do this.
I know, like, even the way that I saw it when I first read it, when Pete was telling me about it and I first read it, I look at it like this. Like, you want to remove yourself from people that are not fruitful in your life, that always bring you down, that always knock every idea, every vision, everything that God has given you and trying to build you up to do. That's the kind of people that they're talking about here.
Well, I mean,
that will kind of, you know, be talked about.
What was Paul saying here? What was Paul saying? Look. I want to just kind of go over this again. He says, they will be boastful and proud, scoffing at God, disobedient to their parents and ungrateful. They will consider nothing sacred. They will be unloving and unforgiving. They will slander others and have no self-control. They will be cruel and hate what is good. They will betray their friends and be reckless. And they will be puffed up with pride. Listen, Paul was talking about, he's talking about the dangers in the last days. The last days, we're in the last days. Back then, the last days is described, there's a time frame between when Jesus ascended to be with the Father to when he returns. So any in that moment, that is the last days. Those are considered the last days. Okay, now I'm not going to try to get into the whole theological, you know, times and raptures. We're not doing that on this program. But I will say that when Paul was talking to him, Timothy was pastoring. He was leading, and he was an apostle, and he was, and Paul was telling him, listen, get ready, because in this time,
right. He's counseling him and giving him advice.
But he's talking about the church. Mm-hmm. He's not talking about people that are lost. He's not talking about the unbeliever. He is saying the church.
Right.
Listen to this. He was talking about people that know the Lord. People that know God. Now, how is this? Now, we ask a question. We ask this question. Stay away from them. How is this kingdom? And maybe you're just tuning in. You saw the title, you know. Listen, we're talking out. We're speaking out of 2 Timothy, chapter 3. Let me go back to this. I want to read this, and this is what he says. Because see, he's talking to the church. Paul is writing about the church, and in verse 5 he says they will act religious. It says they will act religious. But they will reject the power that could make them godly.
Mm-hmm. It would be the same as the Pharisees.
Yes.
That's exactly what that is. Because the Pharisees thought that they, because they had the robes, because they dressed a certain way, because they had all the big rings, because they were in a position in the church, they felt that automatically they would be godly.
Yeah.
But they weren't, because they were moving out of that religious spirit and judging people and just moving not of the Spirit of the Lord. And so that's pretty much what they're talking about here. They're talking about people that are moving with all this stuff. And, you know, one thing that I was having a conversation, I don't know if it was with my pastor or somebody, but I was having a conversation where, like, the enemy is not going to come after the people that are lost, because they're already lost. The enemy is not going to come and put try to put these seeds of thought into those people that are out there living of the world, because they're already in agreement with it. But the enemy's going to come and try to sow those seeds into those that are believers, that are in the church, that are actively in leadership position, to begin to put these seeds that really are a replica of what they're talking about here. And pride begins to boast up when you put a label on somebody. It's really sad to say that, but I've seen it time and time again, even with people that have been years in ministry. I've seen it in my travels, and I'm like blown away, because I'm like, when when do you think that you've arrived? I was like, we don't arrive until we're sitting on the throne with the Lord, just by him in heaven, and we're gone off this earth. That's when we've arrived. But when we feel in the natural, we've arrived in a place where we have a right to be prideful, or that people owe us something, or any of those things, it is not the Lord. It is not Holy Spirit. I mean, if anybody has any of that right, would be Holy Spirit. And Holy Spirit does not function that way. Holy Spirit has seen every war. Holy Spirit has been there for every single part of every part of the kingdom of God.
Yeah.
And Holy Spirit does not function that way. Does Holy Spirit, would Holy Spirit have that right? Yes, but it wouldn't be the character and nature of the kingdom of God to function in that manner. It wouldn't.
Right. That's true. You know, and I like what it says here, because you know what? And when we get to verse 5, where he's talking about this part where he says that the religious, that part right there, the religious, they will act religious. That means that there is some form of godliness in them. That means there is some form of acknowledgement of the Lord. It says they will act religious,
right?
But they will deny the godly. They will deny the godly, which means that these are leaders,
right?
These are leaders in the church. See, he wasn't just talking to the unbeliever. He was talking about the peril that was coming in the end times right now in the church. He was talking about what we're dealing with right now.
Yes.
You know, and look, I just want to be transparent, and I want to be, you know, some people watching, like, well, why are you going there? I'm just going to go there. Because I feel like there's an anointing for us to break the assignment. You know what? This thing about self-appointedness, apostles and prophets and preachers and teachers, and everybody has their own agendas, and everybody is doing stuff.
Yeah, I've seen people get offended because we don't address them by their label.
They
get offended and bothered because I didn't call them by their label. I called them by their name, and they were in offense and they were bothered by it. And I was like, wow. You need that label for your identity of who you are. You need that to establish yourself on a daily basis. That's really sad, because we should have our identity in him, in Christ.
Amen.
And not in our labels.
Listen, everybody is and I'm here when I say everybody, I'm not talking about people, and I'm not like, what I am saying is that if the shoe fits, wear it, and then let's be broken of that today. You right. See, the Lord is he's exposing the plans of the enemy today.
Right.
Amen. So what I want to do is I want to pray that right now, Father, right now in the name of Jesus, we just break every assignment, every demonic assignment over the body, over the church right now in Jesus' name. Lord, that even this morning, God, that even words that are going to be coming against this program, God, that you would shut the mouth of the enemy. And you would render him powerless, and you would break every tooth of the wicked right now. We break that demonic spirit. We come against that spirit of religion, God. We just come against it right now. Lord, that even now that you would come and you would begin to open the waves, Lord, and you would remove the beavers from the dams, remove the dams, and you would break it. The rivers would begin to flow this morning, right now. Truth would be released. Truth and revelation would be released. Right now, in Jesus' name, in Jesus' name. You know, we cannot get to a place of motives and agendas. You know, we talk about the apostles and we talk about the leaders. Paul, this is what Paul was talking about right now. In this time,
Paul was a true apostle.
Well, yeah, but this is what he was this is what he was talking about. He was giving, this is something that was written back then, and he was giving, it was a prophetic picture of what they were dealing with then, but even now to where we're at right now. He said that they would act religious and they would do the things, and they would, I mean, let's read it again. Let me just read it, because let me just look this up again. Hold on 1 second. Okay, here we go. I want to read this again. They will be unloving and unforgiving. They will slander others and they will have no self-control. They will be cruel and hate what is good. They will betray their friends. They will be reckless. They will be puffed up with pride and love the pleasure rather than God. They will act religious and they will reject the power that could make them free. Listen, they would reject the power. That means that there is a spirit of deception that is blinding their eyes, that they would act religious and they would think that they're doing the godly things. But the truth is, they're moving from a different spirit, and they're doing it all right under the label of Jesus.
Right. Well, I like the way we were having this conversation with our pastor one day, and I love this part, because the people back then, even when Jesus was walking, the religious people back then were coming against the power and what Jesus was walking in that moment. And in the Old Testament, they had been talking about the Messiah, the Messiah, the Messiah. And they were so blinded that when the Messiah walked on the earth and literally came in their face, they denied him. They denied the power that he walked in. They denied everything about what Jesus was bringing to them, the kingdom of God. And they never, ever, ever realized that the Messiah they had been talking about all along in the Old Testament was standing right in front of them. Yeah. They missed it. Because this when you're in religion, it's like this blinders come in front of you and you can't see beyond that veil. You can't see beyond those walls. You can't see past what's in front of you. So they literally miss the opportunity to capture the vision Jesus brought to them about the kingdom of God being effective on the earth. And for years and generations, they had talked about the Messiah coming. There's a Messiah coming, a Messiah coming. And the Messiah finally comes, and they missed it. Because they were so caught up in their own agendas, in their pride, in their boastfulness, and all those things that we were reading about in 2 Timothy 3. And if you think about that in the natural, you're like, how could they miss it? How could they not get that the Messiah they had talked about, generation, they raised up their kids knowing about the Messiah that was coming, and they missed it when it actually happened?
Yeah.
I don't want to be that person who misses the opportunities and the things God has over self-ambition or self-pride. That's why I tell the Lord all the time, I'm like, search me out, God. Rip away, tear away the wheat, tear it away, tarry the wheat of what's not good and what's good, what's from you and what's not from you. That I would come before you for you to allow you to come in me to tear away what is not of you.
Yeah.
And if you feel that that's you right now, that 2 Timothy 3, there's a way out. You don't have to stay in that place anymore. Mm-hmm. If you're looking back, see, we have a Holy Spirit inside of us, and we get checks all the time in our spirit. And it's our choice if we're going to listen to the checks of Holy Spirit when Holy Spirit comes and says, man, you were wrong. Like, what you're doing is wrong. The way you're behaving is wrong. And it's really up to us if we're going to really receive that from the Holy Spirit. Well, that gives us that check in that moment.
You know, and that's all true. But, you know, what we're saying is we read in chapter 3 here, all those areas, none of those things reflect the character of God.
Right.
You know, and I know I sound like a broken record, and I'm gonna keep saying this because it's important that if we don't know who God is, we won't be able to to communicate the heart and the nature of our Father.
Well, yeah, how we perceive God is how we're going to release God even to our congregations and people we minister to.
Yeah, and in verse 3 it says they will be unloving and unforgiving. They will slander others. They will be cruel. They will betray their friends and be reckless. You see, that's a toxic church.
It is.
That is a toxic bride. And we label the name of the show this morning, Stay Away From Them. You know, how is that even kingdom? I'm going to tell you what, it is okay for you to stay away from that. You know, as a matter of fact, not only do I say stay away from, but I would say run. If you are in a church where you're being asked to call the apostle, run. You don't need to. That's not what it looks like. Right. If you're in a place where you're being controlled or you're being made to do things, run. If you're in a place where you're hearing gossip and slander and you're hearing things that are not resonating the heart of the Father, run. Because that is not safe for you. That is not what the church is supposed to look like. The church is supposed to look like the heart of the Father and love and to nurture. When your brother falls, that you get there and you're there to pick them up.
Well, it's supposed to carry each other's crosses that, when the other person can't.
It says that the righteous man falls.
We forget to lay down levers.
The righteous man falls 7 times, but he gets back up. Mm-hmm. You see, it's not about kicking people when they're down. So you know what, for me, and I'm just going to be honest, I will run from that. Because there's a call in our lives, there's a call in your life. You're watching right now, you have a call, a destiny, and a purpose. And the enemy will do whatever he can to put roadblocks in front of you to stop you from getting where you need to be. And that includes using people and believers. Now remember, we do not battle against flesh and blood, and it's not a person, it's a spiritual thing.
Right.
But see, Paul is telling us right here in 2 Timothy, he's telling the church, listen, all these people, and they're gonna do it in the name of the Lord. They're doing it in the, they're being slanderous, they're backbiting. They're the sheep killing the sheep.
Yes.
And it's the bride. It's the church. It's you and I, because you and I are the church. You're the church. You see? And that's why he's telling in this verse in 2 Timothy, he's saying, run. But the words he's using is stay away from them. Mm-hmm. Now listen, I believe everybody has a portion in the kingdom. And if your portion is there to help lead them and to show them a different way, then God speed and God power, because there's assignments that the Lord will let you be in. But I'm going to tell you what, if that's not your portion, you don't need to be there. Run. I'm telling you what, we have to look from the eyes of the Lord, from the lenses of our Father, and see what he says about us. Because, you know, the last time I looked and the last time I read, the apostles were the bottom. They were on the bottom. They were persecuted.
Well, they were called to undergird things. They were called to lift up the body of Christ. That's why they were on the bottom, too.
Yeah.
It's the opposite, the pyramid. It's not the apostle on the top and everybody else comes, bows down before them, and everybody else of leadership is below them. It's the opposite. It's the apostle coming and undergirding everything of the body of Christ is trying to do with every person, positioning them and establishing them in who they're called and created to be in Christ.
Yes.
That's what it's supposed to look like. It's supposed to be healthy. That when you're around your apostles or around your leaders, that they speak good of people, that they speak honoring, that they're honoring to other people, other leaders.
That's right.
It's like, why do you think that anything else would be received in the kingdom of God? You know what? Jesus was, he was about honoring. I mean, golly, he honors us every day. When we make our mistakes and we mess up, he honors us by showing up every day to be here with us. Mm. No matter what we look like or the mistakes we make, he shows up every day to be by our side, no matter what, without fail, unconditional love. Now, if that's what Jesus does and we're supposed to look like our Father, then what gives us any right to judge or to speak badly about another brother or sister? Mm. If anything, we need to get on our knees and begin to pray and have intercession and bring breakthrough to those areas that need the effect and the touch of the love of the Father. Mm. You know, sometimes we even begin to make decisions based on the relationship we had with our Father. We think our Father in the natural is the way Jesus is. And that's so untrue. That's not true at all. God had to come in my life and show me new things that my mother and my father didn't teach me growing up. And I had to be receptive of it, and I had to learn the new way, the kingdom way of living, and it didn't look anything like the way my mother and father taught me. So if that's the way your family ran, if that's the way you were taught, it's not going to compare to the kingdom of God and the way the Father really wants you to run in the kingdom with him. It's going to be different. It's going to look different.
Yeah.
And it's going to feel different. It's going to feel good. I'm just speaking truth here. In the culture of the Hispanic culture, there's a lot of pride. I know I grew up in it. You know, it's who has the better car, who's making more money, who's doing this more, who's doing that. And I
who has
there,
more people in yeah, their church?
Who has more people in their church?
Come on, let's just somebody.
We take those traditions of man and we try to put them in the church, and you can't do that. The traditions of man will never fit in the box of the kingdom of the Lord. It doesn't work that way. So you get on board with the Lord and ask him to show you, God, what is your will? What is your way? What is your spirit, Holy Spirit? How does it function? How if the Holy Spirit is a comforter, then why would we feel like we can't be a comforter like Holy Spirit? We're supposed to comfort those in need, those that are hurting, those are that are bruised and beaten down. We have to come and bring healing to them. Even the sickness in the body, that's what Jesus was about when he walked the earth. He was always about bringing relief to the body, bringing relief to the sick, bringing relief to the tormented ones, bringing relief to all those. And if your people that are assigned to you this season don't look like that, then really pray and ask God to send you those that look that way, that want to bring relief to the body of Christ, to show them the kingdom way.
Amen. That's right. That's right. We're gonna take a quick break. If you're tuned in right now, if you're watching on if you're listening on RadioJesus.com, we hope you guys are enjoying the program. We're talking about out of 2 Timothy chapter 3, and we're titling it. I forgot the title. What was the title, Alice?
Stay away from them.
Stay away from them. But anyways, we'll be right back. Don't go anywhere. You're listening to RadioJesus.com. If you're watching on Facebook Live, go ahead and share this right now. Share this with your friends and your followers and invite people to watch. Amen? Come on.
Be a voice to this generation by joining our team of pastors. Broadcast with us today by calling 1-888-406-9115. Again, that's 1-888-406-9115. Hey, have you heard? We have a great team of pastors that broadcast Monday through Friday, sharing the heart of Christ. Be a part of the team impacting the nations. To join our team of pastors, please contact us at 888-406-9115. Again, that's 1-888-406-9115. We look forward to hearing from you.
Hi, this is Susie Uriah. Hey, this is Rick Pino.
This is Joshua Mills.
And you're listening to www.radioairjesus.com.
Welcome back. Welcome back, everybody. RadioAirJesus.com. We hope you guys are having a great time. This morning, we're talking about... Gosh, I keep forgetting the title.
Stay away from them.
Oh, yes. So, again, I just want to welcome everybody who's tuned in with us on the Radio Air Jesus. Maybe you're... if you don't know, we have an app. And it's redone. It's been revamped. And it works great. So, if you have an Apple, an iPhone, an Android, an iPad... You can go and download the free app. It's absolutely free. You can get it for free and, you know, hang out with us when we do our programs. We got a lot of programming that we do Monday through Friday. Amen. So, again, I want to invite you guys, if you're watching on our Facebook Live, share this broadcast. Invite your friends. On the bottom of the screen, this little button you put invite your friends. Let people watch this. Let us know where you're watching from. Comment. We want to hear your comments. Let us know where you're tuned in from. Let us know where you're watching. Let us know if you have any prayer requests. We want to pray with you. On the bottom of the screen, there's going to be a phone number you can call. We have a toll-free number 24 hours a day. We want to pray with you. Doesn't matter what it is. We just want to pray with you and see breakthrough. But again, we've been talking about staying away from them and what that looks like. Maybe you've just joined us and we're reading out of 2 Timothy chapter 3. And... the part that I want to read this one last... I should have brought my other one.
I have it here.
You have it?
Yeah.
Can you read verse 5 for me?
Sure. It says, let me start from the beginning so they can get it, because it's all kind of glued together.
Okay.
So it's 3, 2 Timothy 3. But mark this, there will be terrible times in the last days. People will be lovers of themselves, lovers of money, boastful, pride, abusive, disobedient to their parents, ungrateful, unholy, without love, unforgiving, slanderous, without self-control, brutal, not lovers of the good, treacherous, rash, conceited, lovers of pleasure rather than lovers of God, having a form of godliness but denying its power.
Having a form of godliness but denying its power. You know, so... Again, we were talking about this, and really what Paul was saying here was he was writing to the church and giving him an insight of what was going on in the church and what was to come. So I really believe that's even now where we're at, guys, that this is a plan of the enemy. This is one of the schemes of the enemy. But today, I just feel like today, this morning, I woke up at like 6 o'clock in the morning, and the Lord just put this on my heart. And I just saw like the Lord... removing scales. Now I'm even seeing people right now, like in the spirit, I'm seeing there's somebody who's listening or watching. I don't know what it is, but you're listening. You've been wounded in the church, and today the Lord wants to remove every wound and every offense that the enemy has tried to attach to you. So right now, if that's you, write us, let us know. I want to pray with you. I'm going to pray with you either way. I'm going to pray right now. But I just feel like the Lord is about to remove the scales and the blinds over the eyes. And there's healing that's coming forth right now. There is healing from leaders that were operating out of this. You see, and you know, and we got to love them. We have to love them where they're at. We really do. And we have to recognize that that's not who they are. You see, listen. We must know this. We must know who God is. And I keep referring back to this because it's important. We must have a revelation of who God is. Because who God is and who He is inside of us, we're able to know who we are and our identity. That whenever we speak something that would be like out of 2 Timothy 3, that whatever we speak, if it's not lined up with the character and nature of God, that it's not of God, it's not of the kingdom. So therefore, if your leaders, maybe the Lord has you in a place right now where the leaders of your ministry or the church, wherever, maybe the Lord's working through some things with them. You see, everybody's growing.
Of course, nobody's going to be perfect. I mean, we're all in those situations, but we're talking about deliberately being this way.
Yes.
I mean, there's people out there that don't mean to be that way, or they fall, you know, and they have problems and issues and things like that, and that's different. But when you're deliberately living this way, you know, and you're purposely making these choices to be this way in the body of Christ, you know, and these are the people that are supposed to be reading the word. If you keep on reading, it talks about how the how God's breath is on the word, and it equips and trains us to walk in righteousness for the good work. I mean, if you keep reading on in that chapter, it talks about that. So that very thing that they're talking about, it's like, you've got to know your word too. You've got to know what the truth of the Lord is.
Amen. Amen, amen. I'm sorry, I'm reading stuff that's coming in here. So listen, the identity of Christ inside of you. So what I want to do is I want to pray for those right now. Because see, what the Lord reveals, he always heals. You see, he does. So I'm going to pray right now for those leaders and pastors, the prophets, the evangelists, the teachers, the apostles, right now. Lord, that you would begin to show them your heart and you would show them your way right now in Jesus' name. Lord, whatever wrongdoings, whatever the situations are in their region, God, that you would give them eyes to see and ears to hear what your Spirit is saying, Lord. Lord, I just ask for a fresh wind of revelation to come right now in Jesus' name. Let the winds of change begin to blow. We come against a spirit of deception right now. We come against a spirit, this demonic spirit that would try to come. I break even leeching spirits right now. I come against witchcraft in the church. I come against churchy witchcraft. I come against the rebellion in the church right now, God. Every assignment that is trying to hold back the bride, God. Lord, we just break those curses and those roots off right now, Lord. Lord, words of men, assignments of man, agendas of man, God, Lord, that you would release the bride right now, Lord. Whatever it is, God, that they would be totally free right now in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name, Lord. Release, release, release. Holy Ghost. Holy Ghost. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. Jesus. You know, even that we would be able to walk in a humility state, a state of humbleness, a state of humility, Lord. Lord, that you would be put first, God. That we wouldn't hide behind facades of words, God, but that we would walk in your glory and your presence, God, right now. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. I got a prayer request that came in. I want to pray for David Garza. He's praying for his scan results. Father, in the name of Jesus, we just pray for David right now. Healing virtue to be released, God. The virtue of heaven to be released right now. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. I want to say hello to everybody who's tuning in right now. I'm getting multiple messages here, so God bless you guys. God bless you all. Again, the prayer line number is going to be 1-888-406-9115. That's 888-406-9115. Welcome back. Welcome back, Radio Air Jesus. God bless you guys. Hope you guys are having a great time this morning. Again, it is 10:57 Central Standard Time, coming to you live from San Antonio, Texas. Come on. It's nice and chilly day. Nice and chilly day. You know what's great about chilly days is you get to have a nice big cup of warm hot coffee.
Hot cocoa.
With real creamer.
You get with real creamer. Oh my God.
For those who don't know, go back and watch my Facebook post and you'll have a better understanding what I'm talking about. I wanna read a couple things that came in. Rachel wrote, "How do you continue to minister to others when you feel like yourself you're not okay? Like mentally. I feel like I'm struggling and it really makes me doubt. Like I said yesterday, I don't want to be that person for sure." You want to answer that? I mean,
yeah, I mean, you're going to have good days and you're going to have bad days. It doesn't mean that something's wrong with you or like, don't take that on, because a lot of the times it's us that stop the flow of the river inside of us. It's us in our minds that automatically assume things and speak things to ourselves. So in this, in those moments where the enemy comes and whispers to you of that you're not qualified, or that you messed up, or you made a bad decision, you have to shut that mouth of the enemy and begin to stand firm in who God says you are.
Yeah.
Because God says you're wonderfully made in His image. And there's so much purpose and destiny inside of each and every one of us that we cannot allow ourselves to receive what the enemy wants to bring to us. None of us are going to be perfect in doing the things of God. None of us are going to be in this perfect place where we're in a little bubble, like everybody makes mistakes, you know? But we can't stay in those mistakes. We have to learn from them and move forward.
Yeah, you know, I want to just chime in a little bit on that, Rachel, because it all really goes back to, like we said before in the beginning, is to have an understanding who God is. Because see, even the comment, like with the question that you're asking, is I feel like I'm struggling, and it really makes you doubt. Well, what happens is because we don't have an understanding of who God is. That's the truth, is because the nature and the heart for Father is not that you would struggle, but that you would be able, you would be victorious, and you would move forward.
We're called to be overcomers.
That's right. So by you knowing who God is, you know who you are and who God is inside of you. You see, it all stems back to understanding who God is in our lives. Amen? You know, I want to read, I'm reading, Mary M. Thompson wrote, we are supposed to pray for our pastors in the body of, in the church. Absolutely.
Yes.
Absolutely. Let me tell you what, that is very key, because see, I don't believe anybody, you know, and I could be wrong, but I don't believe anybody ever goes into ministry with the intent to hurt people.
No, they don't.
They don't.
They don't.
They don't go in the with the intent to slander or to do those things that they talked about in 2 Timothy. They don't. But what happens is the enemy will come and will begin to bring things to them, and they begin to agree with it. Let me take an example of
and
that.
And entertain them.
And entertain the thoughts.
Right.
For example, a person who has a heart to travel the nations. All of a sudden they travel the nation. And now they think they're like a prophet to the nation. And now they think that they're holier than thou. And now they request a certain type of water. Now they request a certain amount of money. Now they have an honorarium of so many thousands of dollars. You see, what happens is, that's what that scripture talks about, like their pride being puffed up. You see, no longer does it become about Jesus and the kingdom, but it becomes about self-promotion. It becomes about the agendas of man. It does. It becomes about a title and entitlement. You know, you said something earlier, and I've had the same thing happen to me where I was actually corrected by somebody one time because I did not call them an apostle or a prophet. Prophet so-and-so or prophetess so-and-so. Like, they actually said, no, I'm prophetess so-and-so. You see, we cannot allow our identities be in a title.
Right.
Because if you really want a title, I believe the best title you can have is going to be the sons of God, the friend of God.
Yeah, we're
I want to be a friend of God. I want to walk in the cool of the day with the Father in the garden, hand in hand, like, Lord, where you would tell me your secrets. That's the ultimate. Like, gosh, who just wants to be if you're a prophet, great. If you're an apostle, great. But who just wants to be that?
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Right.
I'm just, you know, and I know that I'm touching on some areas, and then there's people that are gonna watch this later, and you're gonna, you know, you're probably judging it already. You know, and I'm gonna pray for that you don't judge it.
Well, I had this person ask me the other day, you know, what do I call you? Do I call you pastor? Do I call you apostle? What do I call you? I said, you call me by my name. You call me Alice.
Yeah.
And they like gave me this look, like, what? And I was like, yeah, I said, because I'm a daughter of the King, just like you are. And the only difference between me and you is that I just keep saying yes to Him. And all you have to do is start saying yes to Him too. And you can do everything that I'm walking and doing yourself.
Yeah.
There is no limit. There is, God wants to use every single one of us out there. there is not one person that he is not wanting to use as a willing vessel just to say yes to him.
Amen.
There's no difference whether you have a degree or no degree. Man, I've had people that received the Lord and they've gotten tons more revelation than I've gotten, you know? And it's all because the Spirit of the Lord, Holy Spirit, comes and downloads to them all kinds of things because of their yes.
Yeah.
And I'm okay with that. I'm like excited for when people come to the Lord and God starts manifesting himself on them in such a powerful way. I get excited about it because
that's what the kingdom looks like.
I want to see others around me blessed. I want to see others around me function and begin to move in what God has. And it's never about me or a title or any of that. I want to see people be established and be closer to Jesus. That's all.
Amen. 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 Holy Ghost. Again, we got somebody who just said, thank you for the person who answered my prayer line, the person who answered my call. Thank you so much for calling the prayer line. Yes. I pray you are blessed. You know, I really do. And
we have a great team here. We're thankful for our team. Yes. Oh, my God. We have such a great team.
We have people that are behind the scenes right now. You see us on the camera. You see us on radio. And I mean, you hear us on the radio. And there's so much that goes on behind the scenes, guys. And I just want to honor our team for everything that they do.
Yeah.
Just
they
the
come
faithfulness.
In sick. They come in not feeling good sometimes.
Yes.
And they just push through.
Amen. Amen.
We're on the road and we're with our cameras and they push through.
Yes.
So we're very thankful for them.
So good. You know, I want us, we're gonna pray. We're gonna pray some before we close out. I know that. I just feel like the Lord wants to do something right now. You know, it's interesting because back in the day when we first started Radio Jesus, it was like we had no agendas. Remember, it was just like it's like whatever happened, we would be live on the radio and the Spirit of the Lord would fall in the room. Mm-hmm. And then we would even be on live stream at that time and everybody would be on the floor on their face. And the music would be playing on the radio station and people would be watching and the music would just stop because everybody was like out in the Spirit of the Lord. Like, this is live. Like, and it didn't matter. It didn't matter. You know, like, it was like there was no agenda. So I think we have to get back to that place in our lives and our walk. You know, even you're listening, that we have to get back to that place of the first love.
Right.
Like, I even see somebody right now, the Lord is reminding you when you first started. Like, I just see that. I just see, like, the Lord is reminding you of when you first started. Come on. That's so good. Hope is being released right now. Hope. Hope is being released. Wow. I even believe somebody's listening. Your name is even Hope. Is even Hope. Hope. Hope, you're being released right now. Hope is being released, but hope you're being released right now to do your call. It's like, now is the time. Wow, that's great.
That's good.
Jesus, Holy Ghost.
Well, we have a new year coming our way this weekend.
Yes.
I can't even believe it. I was telling Pete the other day, I was like, I just want to stop time. It feels like Thanksgiving, Christmas, everything came so fast. But I really believe in the Spirit. There's something happening.
Yeah.
There's an acceleration in the Spirit that's going on right now. And God is like, let's just hurry up and get to the next thing. Like, for everybody was in a waiting mode, like, let's wait, wait, wait. And all of a sudden, like, I just feel in the Spirit, oh, that there's just an acceleration that's happening right now where you're at. That the weariness, the tiredness would be completely pulled off of you. And God is just slinging you back to begin to launch you out to some really amazing, powerful new things for the new year. And I was sitting there, you know, I've been on Facebook and seeing everybody's releases for the new year and the new harvest and all these great things.
Shakalaka.
And I've been watching and listening. So I asked the Lord last night, I went to bed. Look, I'm not saying this past year was perfect, because it wasn't perfect this past year, but it was the will of God.
Amen.
Every part of your life was in that will of God, where he came in and he rescued you in times where you needed him so badly. He came in those times and gave you what you needed when you needed it. And so we have to get into our Thanksgiving mode for real. Like last night when I went to sleep, I was just thanking the Lord for people he's connected us with. I was thanking the Lord for every opportunity we had this past year. Thanking him for those that stepped out in faith with us in building and visionating and all these things. And when I stepped in that place of thanksgiving, that's when I felt the presence of the Lord and God's Spirit fell on me. And that's where we need to be. Not be in the complaining and murmuring and the would've, could've, should've of this past year. Because did things happen out in the world? Of course they did. There was horrible things that happened. But you know what? God, you know, we were listening to this song going home last night. God is still the King of the world. He is still the King of the world, the owner, the maker of everything in the world. And so our perspective, our view is going to change this next season. It's going to change for 2017. And we just need to lock our eyes on Jesus and sit back and watch the great things he's about to do. He's about to step on some land with his foot and just bring forth the power that he carries.
Yeah.
He's going to step one of his feet moving forward on the land, and he's going to take hold of what righteously belongs to him because of what he did for us. And we just have to begin to come in agreement with the Spirit of the Lord and what God is saying for 2017. And let's not fight the Spirit of the Lord anymore. Let's not fight what he created you to do this next season. Things are so much easier when you don't fight.
Yeah.
When you just say yes and let God lead you, and you just grab onto God's hand and he leads you in every single part of your life, it's just easier that way. But if you're sitting there, no God, I don't want to, God, I don't want to do this, I don't know about this, God, you're fighting him. And so this year, get into a place where you're no longer fighting what he's trying to get you to do. He's speaking to you every single day. You just have to listen. I hear people say it. I mean, recently, this past week, I had like 3 people tell me, it's like crickets. I don't hear anything. No, he is speaking to you, but maybe not the way that you want to hear him. He may be saying things to you right now that you don't want to do those things he's saying to you, but he's speaking, you know? So 2017, it's going to be easier. Things are going to get easier. I know the people of the world are speaking that things are going to get harder and all this stuff. People are in panic right now and they're living in fear for this next coming year. But through prayer and intercession, God is going to make a way for us to have everything we need and to be overcomers and to establish what he's trying to do here on the earth. And we just get to come along for the ride. I really believe this year is going to bring excitement. It's going to bring this great joy and hope that Pete keeps talking about, this hope. And things are going to be made easy. You know, the enemy, his tactic is to rob you of your joy. And the joy of the Lord is your strength. So if you don't have joy in your life, you're going to get weary and tired real quick. But if you can have laughter and joy in your life every day, the strength of the Lord, the Spirit of the Lord gets excited with you and begins to move on your behalf to make things happen that you never thought were possible. So I want to just do like a quick declaration and a prayer for this coming up year that things will get easy. I was driving down this street, and I know Pete shared this yesterday on a Facebook Live, but I was driving down the street and the Lord began to show me where us in times past have tried to make things happen in our own power, in our own means, by pioneering and digging up the ground with our hands when he's made tools and made so many different kinds of tools. I was passing by, you know, about a month ago, I was driving by and there was like all different kind of plowers. sitting in this big old yard, and they were all different shapes, and some were big and some were little and some were... So God has specific flowers of instruments and tools he's going to give us this next year to make our lives easier. And it's not going to be us having to dig up stuff with our own power, with our own hands. It's going to be easy because he's giving us the tools and the means to make things easier for ourselves. We don't have to do things the hard way anymore, how our mothers and our fathers and our ancestors did things. But now we're going to have to start walking in the new thing he's trying to show us with the easier way for 2017. Yeah. And if we just beckon to his voice and to his spirit, things will be easy. I'm telling you, it's going to be easy. It's not going to be this rush, heaviness type of thing.
Yeah.
It's God's just beginning to relieve some stress right now. God's beginning to relieve you of some things that you've been holding on to. Give it all to him.
Yeah.
He knows what to do with it. Just let everything right now, before we enter the next year, let everything go that is not of God. Let everything go. Stress, worry, sickness, whatever it is you're trying to hold on to, let it go and give it to God.
That's right.
Because he knows what to do with it.
Yeah. I really saw the Lord even right now dealing with people that are dealing with addictions. Like addictions are being released and they're being removed from your life right now. And I feel like even somebody who's been battling I'm not going to say what it is, but you've been battling something in your mind. So right now that even that battle is leaving you right now. It's leaving you. You know, and I know that for 2017, we can do a whole show on that right now, but I'm not released just yet. But in January, we're going to be releasing a prophetic alert like we did last year. And really going to be speaking to you about what's going on for the year that's coming, a prophetic word for 2017. And I will say this, what I am able to release right now, one thing that I know that the Lord is speaking, he says that 2017 is the year of revival. It is. It's the year of revival. And we're going to see it. We're going to see the Lord is already doing it. There's pockets that are birthed up right now. And we're going to see a move of God that we haven't seen before. And it's going to be real. And it's not going to be led by an agenda of man, but it's going to be led by a sovereign move of God. Amen. So 2017, if I can share something with you on that right now, that I'm able to, is that 2017 will be ushered in by revival, a move of God, a wave of his presence in the nation and beyond. Amen. Come on. I'm going to tell you what I know that a lot of people don't know, and they may not agree with the politics and all that stuff, but even Trump being elected as president, that's a major shift.
Yes,
that's a major shift. And not because of what he does or who he is or
it
just
has nothing to do with him.
Because it came from a totally unexpected place.
Mm-hmm.
It came from where nobody ever thought it would happen, but it's coming. And it's going to make change.
And it's in the not understanding is where God's at.
Yeah.
People till this day are trying to figure out what happened.
Yeah.
They're, because it was so crazy how that came about. And only God can do the not understanding. God is right smack in the middle of your not understanding what's going on right now.
So we need to pray for our president-elect, Donald Trump. We need to pray for Israel. We need to pray that justice would be released right now. That every plan of the enemy would be broken right now in Jesus' name. Come on. I just felt an authority in that. Like, devil, you know you lost. Mm-hmm. You've lost. So let's pray. Let's pray that. Let's pray that prayer. You want to lead into that prayer, and then we're gonna close off for our show.
Yes, God, we just come in Thanksgiving with you, God, for everything that we got to be a part of this past year, God, for every opportunity, every door that you opened to us this past season, God. And we don't look at anything bad, God, because everything is good in your kingdom, God. Every part that you give us is your goodness wrapped around us, God. And so we give you thanksgiving this morning for every single part that we were a part of, God. And we just speak blessings and blessings to your children all around the world, God, that you would come and touch them, that they would feel your presence and your Holy Spirit right now, wherever they're listening from, wherever they're watching from, God, that they would feel a touch of your finger, of your hand this morning, God, and they will know that you love them, that your love and your presence will overwhelm them even right now, God, that they would know that there is a true God and that you're real, God, and that you're bringing change into their lives. You're bringing good changes, God. Changes that will affect generation after generation, God. So we just call on every generation right now. Right now, God, we speak to every age group out there listening, God, and watching, God, that they would be pulled by your Spirit to come closer to you, God. Because without you, Lord, we are nothing, God. Without you, Lord, we have nothing, God. We need you, God. And so we just pull on your garment right now, God, that we would become closer to you. We would begin to hear your heartbeat again and what it sounds like and what it feels like, God, for this next year, God. And what motivates us, what gets us going is your heart, God. Your heart for your people, your love for your children, God. That we're pulled by your Spirit to begin to move in those areas, God, by the pulling of our hearts, that we begin to come in alignment with your heart this morning, God. That the way your heart functions and moves, we would be in alignment with that, God.
Amen.
Yes, Lord.
Amen. That's good. We hope you guys are enjoyed and we're blessed this morning. You know, I want to share before we go. We got a few minutes left of our program, but I want to share just some things we have kind of coming up. You know, this January 5th, 6th, 7th, and 8th, our friend Todd Bentley is going to be with us at the Revival Culture Center here in San Antonio. For more information, go to revivalculturesa.com. It's gonna be a glory gathering. I'm telling you what, it's gonna be glory.
Yeah, whatever you have to do, if you have to get off of work, whatever you have to do, pack your bag and come.
Yes.
Because it's gonna be awesome. I'm so excited to have our friend here. It's gonna be amazing.
And coming up in February, the 24th and the 25th, we're doing a women's conference. Alice will be speaking. Carrie Perkins will be here with us, the Revival Culture Center. It's called Empowered by the King. It's going to be a prophetic conference, women's conference. It's going to be a phenomenal time, man. Really excited about that. We've got some plans for us to possibly be in Las Vegas in March. That might be Las Vegas, Arizona in March. So keep that in prayer. If you would like for us to kind of visit you, go to our website, runwithrevival.com. runwithrevival.com, and we love to connect with you guys. And we also have a big event coming up in San Angelo in April.
We'll be in Katy in Houston.
In Houston in February. That's
right. In the beginning of February.
That's right. We're going to be at the Roar Ministry. You're right. I was the whole month. And on February the 4th, Saturday, we're going to be with the Roar Ministries. We're going to be ministering that Saturday night.
Yes.
With Carrie Richardson. It's going to be a great time. Then Sunday morning, we're going to be at Journey Church in Katy, Texas.
Aww, I love them.
Yeah, it's going to be great. It's going to be so offense. It's going to be so awesome.
You're thinking football here.
I'm thinking football.
Focus.
I'm ready for the Cowboys. No, but yeah, you're right. Awesome. Yeah, people are writing. They're going to be at the conference. Awesome. Thank you so much, Ness. Listen. Also be in prayer for us. I'm leaving on the 5th of February to India for like 8 or 10 days. And we're going to go and we're just going to see the glory. I'm really believing for revival in India. I'm just believing for it. You know, revival in India. We're going to be in Ghaziabad, India. We're just going to be releasing the pastors and ministers there and teaching them how to walk in the glory and the power of God.
Yeah, I really believe He's going to take this fire just to begin to ignite leaders over there.
Yeah, amen.
And so if you have been blessed by the broadcast, if you've been blessed by even listening 24/7, 7 days a week, we have our worship on. Sow that seed into Radio Air Jesus. We get so blessed by even the numbers that have increased these past months. I mean, man, we've been even sharing with our pastors and our ministers about it.
I need to share this because I looked yesterday. We're over 50,000 viewers and listeners. Yay! For the month of December. For the month of December, over 50,000 people have tuned in. 50,000 people.
That is great.
And like Alex was saying, you know what? If you've been blessed, man, sow a seed into Radio Air Jesus.
Yeah, and no, it's you're sowing a seed that goes such a distance than just like Radio Air Jesus. It goes around the world to the nations. And people get fed off of the music, off of the ministries, of the pastors. They get fed by all of this. Some of this is how they get sustained in the spirit and fed. Yeah. So me and Pete just get the opportunity to come and be, you know, come along for the ride and the journey of it. But really, without your help, without your support in all of this, we can't do what we do without your support.
There are some things in ministry that we still need to get and obtain. So listen,
we
want to give you an option right now, an opportunity to partner with us, not just in your prayer, but even in your sowing. Listen, so go to RadioAirJesus.com. There's a green button that says give. Any amount. You can partner with us. You can partner, become a monthly partner with us, or you can give a one-time donation, gift, or an offering. But I want you to know, just like Alice said, that every part that is given goes right back into the nation, whether it's through television or it's through radio, it's through ministry, through travel. Every part is released right back into the nations.
Yes.
So partner with us on that. Amen.
And we want to thank our pastors that have already sown, that have already partnered with us. We're thankful for all our partners that are visionate with us and come to align themselves with us. We're thankful for them. So everybody, Happy New Year.
Happy New Year.
Remember, Happy New Year.
Yes.
Not let's be sad, New Year. It's a Happy New Year to each and every one of you out there. We love you guys. We hope you are safe for the new year and you enjoy your time with your families.
God bless you. We love y'all.